Hello friends, I'm back again with another DIY repurposing and upcycling project for you. So this is again an old salwar of mine, and this is in pure crepe Dacian fabric, which I absolutely love, and I don't wear it any further. I plan to make a crop top out of it along with this scrappy fabric. This is a knitted fabric. It's been lying with me for a long time, so I'm going to make use of both these and then make a crop top. And just for a practice, I had previously made another crop top. Now I'll show you this, opening it. So this was a practice session for me. So I thought that only if I get it right, then I'm going to, as you know that I'm not a seamstress, I just do it as a hobby and a DIY. So this is the one. This was again a pink colored salwar, again in crepe, Dacian crepe. So I made this crop top out of it, which really suits me fine. And just based on this, just taking this idea further, but this time it will be a little bit different because I am going to ultimately wear it, and I don't want two identical pieces in the same kind of crepe fabric. So it will have a little bit of different look, but the main idea would remain the same. So first thing first, I need to rip off all the seams. So using my seam ripper, I'm going to rip off all the stitches, and then planning how to combine it with this knitted fabric, I'll get back to you. I have ripped apart all the seams. I have been extra careful while ironing my cut pieces, because this is not cotton which I am working with, it is crepe, and crepe is not easy to work with, keeps slipping all the time. So your ironing has to be very accurate along the folds. Now what I mean by that is, when I cut my fabric, I get accurate pieces. So for that, what I did was, these are the two pieces from the main body of my salwar, which, as you can see, and this is the panel from the top in which actually we tie our dori. So this panel I won't be requiring now, so I keep it aside. This has also been ironed properly, and what I have done is, the two main body pieces, I have given them a single fold very symmetrically, and then I have ironed it very nicely. Now this fold that I've got while ironing is going to give me accurate bodice pieces for my crop top when I cut it. So this, you have to be very careful. Now one more thing you have to keep in mind, because this is a DIY, I'm not having a full length proper cut piece. So in the salwar you have these two stitches, you can see along the main body, the whole length. Now this will fall in the front as well as the back of your crop top when you're cutting out the fabric. Now if you want to hide these cuts with some extra creativity, I'll show you what I did in the previous crop top which I made from another salwar up close. So I gave these, if you can see properly, I gave these embroidery stitches, pattern stitches, which are installed already in my machine with a twin needle. This makes it look all the more beautiful, you can see. So I generally prefer the zigzag stitch because it gives a very nice and decent look. So before I get into cutting my fabric for the final sewing of my crop top, I need to do the prepping. The first prep would be to give that double needle stitch, the embroidery stitch which I was talking about, along this entire seam line, and also for the other part of the main body, which will actually become the back of my bodice. I also plan to stitch a part of this fabric, the knitted fabric which I was telling you, because I have a good amount of this fabric. It will be on the top of my crop top bodice, and the remaining part of the fabric which will be left, I'll use it for the sleeves. So from this knitted fabric. I've cut out these two panels, gave a single fold, and then placed it here on top and just saw it by an estimation that this is the width to which I want the this cut piece to be on the top of my crop top. So this gets sewn to the main fabric along this length. So I'm also trying to be a little economical and not wasting too much of this fabric, because I know I require it also for the sleeves of my crop top. So knowing that I want this much to be the width of the top of my crop top, accordingly a little 1.5 inch extra I've taken. So I'll just show you what is the width to which I have cut this piece. So it is approximately around 5.5 inch. So the width is 5.5 inch and the length is according to the top of my main bodice. So according that pattern. So both the panels will get stitched to the main body of the crop top before cutting the fabric. So this is the twin needle that I was talking about, and these are the two colors that I have coordinated for the embroidery stitch. So let's get started with that. So along the entire length of these seams, I'll do the same zigzag stitch with twin blade for this as well. So I've set it to zigzag stitch, and now I'll do the embroidery pattern. So I'll show you up close how it looks. So this is how it looks. And just the same way, I'm also going to do for the other side and for the other part of the bodice, the back side, both sides, and then get back to you. I have finished with these patterned embroidery stitches on twin needle on my machine for both the sides of my bodice, and also I have attached this white knitted panel for the top of the bodice on one of the sides. And just the same way, I'll do it for the other part and give you the demo. So what I did was, since this is calculated amount of fabric, so I have to be cautious while I'm stitching it to the main bodice. So what I did was, I folded this panel once and then located the midpoint, and I cut a notch like this. This will help me locate the midpoint. And then, as I have this ironed already with a single fold, so I also know exactly the midpoint of this fabric too. So I match up the two midpoints with the right side facing the right side of this knitted fabric, so that I have the wrong sides facing up. And matching the midpoints, I pin up both the fabric pieces. And now that both the midpoints are matching and I have the equal amount of this knitted fabric on both sides, I am ready to sew it to the main fabric. With a seam allowance of 1/4 inch, I sew the two pieces together. Now that I have given a single back stitch, I also need to give a top stitch on top of this just to give it a good finish. So with coordinated thread, I give it a top stitch very close to the joint. So this is how the fabric piece now looks like, and now I'm ready to cut the fabric for the final sewing. So along this press line I'm going to, because it's exactly the center of my piece, with these two stitches exactly symmetrically equally placed on the two sides of the center, I give it a fold very carefully. And this time I'm not going to cut both the pieces, the back and the front of the bodies together, because this fabric is a little difficult to deal with. I want my accuracy, so I'll cut them one by one. And now on top of this, my crop top, which has been turned over to the wrong side, I place it with a single fold and I'm ready to cut it. Now for the neck, I'll keep half an inch seam allowance for the neck as well as the shoulder as well as the armhole. Now this time even the armhole, because it is not going to be a sleeveless, it will have sleeves in it, so I require the seam allowance here also. But along the sides I don't have to bother, because it already has the seam line along with the fray edges. So I give it a cut. I also want it in the length to be a little longer than this crop top, so I'll also keep around 1 inch more towards the bottom. So the piece is ready. Just the same way, this time I'm not going to make use of this. I'm going to instead use this piece as a reference for cutting the bodice part of the back side. So again I give it a double fold and very accurately matching up the seams, I place it. Along the press line, and on top of this I place the other part of the bodice, match up the seams here so that both the front and the back have the same amount of this netted fabric and there is a symmetry. And also be careful with the main body so that both are on the same line. Now it's perfect and I'm ready to cut it. So both my body parts have been cut, the front and the back. And the front will now have, as I have told you in the previous projects also, that since I need this to have a sleeve, so it will have a deeper cut by half an inch. So the deeper cut is done, and also the neck will be a little deeper by around half an inch again. So both the pieces are done, the front and the back. Now this is a very small piece of fabric and I have to be very very calculated and economical while I'm cutting two sleeves out of it. So first of all I get rid of this extra knitted fabric towards the selvage which doesn't have the embroidery part, so that both the parts look similar. And now I need two pieces for my sleeves, so Again from this side it is uneven, so I'll also cut this out for the even pieces. And now I give it one fold so that I get two exactly similar pieces for my sleeves, and I cut it exactly at the center with this double fold. So I get two pieces, as you can see, for the two sleeves. Now for the sleeves I just give it one fold. Both are, I'm just looking at the embroidery, may not be clearly visible to you. So I have the right side of the embroidery facing inside, and then I have given it a single fold. Same I have done with the other fabric also, with the right side inside. Match them together with the fray edges facing out, and these are the folds along the axis. And here I am going to cut out the sleeves. Now this is again by eyeballing, I am not doing any calculation, so you have to see how I go about it, because it's completely DIY and I am not an expert in tailoring, or I am not a seamstress. Just by matching up the arms with the double fold, I gauge that and I move it along the entire armhole of my main bodice, and this is how I see that the armhole should have be. The length of my armhole for the sleeves should be this much length. So keeping that length, I give it a cut of around 1/2 inch towards the fray side. These are the fray sides for both the pieces of my arms. And now I am going to cut out the sleeves. So around 2.5 inch down, I give a marking towards the fray side, and I make the pattern for cutting the armhole. So along this pattern I am going to cut the armhole. And this also will get a cut like this. And so these are the two arms that I have. You can see. And now the inner side will have a deeper cut as we had it in the main bodice. So I give a deeper cut by 1/2 inch. First of all, I cut a notch at the center for both the pieces. This will help me in finding the center. And now I give towards the front, I give a 1/2 inch deeper cut on my arm, just like this. And if this is one of the arms, for the other arm again I have to be careful. So this will, if this is one of the sides, for the other side of my arms this will be the front. So again 1/2 inch of deeper cut for the arms towards the inside. So both my arms are ready, and now all my prepping is done. I first need to sew the neckline seams, and then we are going to attach the sleeves to the main bodice. To finish the hemline for the neck, I first need to join the shoulders. So for that I first place the right side of one of the bodice part. On top of that I place another bodice part with the right side facing down, so that both the right sides match up. And then I am going to sew the shoulder joints.
with a seam allowance of around 1/4 inch, I sew it. I give one more stitch. So now that both the shoulders have been joined together, I am going to hem the neckline. And for that, I already have this bias binding tape of white color, which absolutely matches up with the neck fabric. So this will come very handy. This I had made long time back. I generally keep bias binding tape in solid colors made quite ahead of time whenever I have the fabric with me, so that I don't waste my time making a tape while I'm sewing. And how to make a bias binding tape, I have a detailed tutorial on my channel. I'll leave a link to that video in my description box below. You can check that out. And now I'm going to use this bias binding tape. This is the total thickness is around 1.5 inches, which has been folded along the edges just to get this kind of a bias binding tape. So let's get started. So I unfold it, and starting from one of the corners of the shoulder joint, and I still have it on the wrong side of the fabric. So now this is the right side of my fabric along the neckline, and I arrange this bias binding tape with the wrong side, right side matching up with the right side of this, and along the shoulder joint seams I leave around 1/4 inch of this fabric of the bias binding tape, and then I start sewing it all around the neckline along this fold. This will act as a reference for my sewing, which is around 1/4 inch. If you want, you can pin it up, but I'll do it just like that. You just have to be very careful while you are making your neckline, because it's a curved edge, so you do not stretch the fabric and let it move freely, and just keep giving a turn slowly around the entire neckline. So you can see that this fold press is acting as my reference for the seam. As I'm reaching the end, I have to be a little slow and giving it a fold of 1/4 inch, which I had actually not sewn in the beginning, the other end. I just fold it for that 1/4 inch. On top of that, I set this so that I have extra 1/4 inch in this open end also of the tape, and then I cut it down. Now matching both the open ends together with this, that extra 1/4 inch, and this, them together, and then I sew both of catching both the folds together, I give it a sew. Slowly. So this finishes up the one side of the hem for the neck, and the other side I'm going to sew it with needle and thread with my hands so that it gives me a neat finish. So I'm ready with my needle and thread, and now I finish up the hem of my neck. Now generally for curved edges, as I have told you earlier, I always give some notches along the fray edges, but since this net is a stretchy fabric, so it will stretch and I don't want to make it loose any further, so I'm not going to cut out any notches. So I straight away start hemming. So this is how I fold it, and then I'm going to give it a hem. So you can just watch me. So this is on the wrong side that I'm hemming, and this is how the neck will look. So this way I'm going to hem along the entire length of the neck for front as well as back, and when I'm going to close the hemline, then I'm going to get back to you. I have hemmed the entire length of the neck and I have finally reached the end point again. So now I'll tell you how to lock it up at the end of this opening of the hemline. So this extra quarter of an inch of fabric which I had left when I was closing the initial end of the hemline to the other side of the neck, you must be remembering. So that extra quarter of an inch, I'll give it a fold and then put it inside the other side of the hemline of the bias binding tape, and then you can see that now how beautifully the ends match up with each other with no fray edges showing. And now I'm going to finish off with my hem. And take your own time. There's no need to hurry. We want a proper finish, and also we also need to see that the bias binding tape has proper width. A little bit of adjustment in the fabric you will have to do of the bias binding tape, little push here and there so that they fit well and evenly placed in thickness. So a few knots here, and I give some couple of back stitches so that I get back to this open joint, and I lock it very nicely with a stitch here, you can see. So I don't have this open end of the bias binding tape where they meet with each other, the end points. And so they are also properly locked, and then I give a knot here and snip off the thread. So my neck is ready. Turn it over to the right side and show it to you. So this is how the neckline looks. When I give it an iron, it is going to sit even better. That we'll do later once we are finished up with the project. So now that the neckline is done, I'm going to sew in the sleeves. So for that, I take the sleeves. Very important that I match up the sleeves in a way that, remembering that firstly, the right side matches with the right side, and secondly, deeper cut which has to fit to the right side of my arm. I'll fix it starting from the shoulder as always. So at the shoulder, I fix the wrong side and the wrong side together with this notch matching up with the shoulder joint, and then I start sewing without giving any stretch on the fabric and sewing slowly. I sew one side and then I sew the other side of the sleeve. So keeping a seam allowance of 1/4 inch and matching the notch of the sleeves with the shoulder joint, I start sewing from one side very slowly and without any stretch in the fabric. One side of the sleeve being sewn to the main bodice, we get to the other side. Again, we start from the shoulder joint and very slowly again. So one arm has been sewn to the main bodice, as you can see, and just the same way I'm going to sew in the other sleeve to the main bodice armhole, and then I get back to you. One side of the arm I have already prepped for the final stitch. So what I've done is, once I stitched it to the main body, the sleeves, I found, because I do DIY, I'm not exact with my measurements of the cuts, so I always cut the arms a little extra by the procedure which I've shown you earlier. So this was also extra length which I trimmed to the same length so that it matches up with the bodice side seams. And after that, the hem of my sleeves, I have done it by picot. So I'll give you a demo for the other side of the sleeves. Now, if you look at these sleeves, and when I try to match up the sleeve free edges with the bodice free edges towards the sides of my body, then you can see that here again I have some extra fabric. Now, this is safe in case this was shorter, in case the sleeves fabric was shorter and this was larger, then you couldn't have cut into the bodice, otherwise it will not fit your body. So that is why when I do my DIYs, I always make it a point that sleeves are a little towards the longer side. So since I don't do exact accurate measurements, so now whatever extra is left here, I just trim it with the slant cut, and now this perfectly matches up. And when I'm finally going to sew it along this entire sides of the body, it is going to match up the free edges. So this is what I have done, and now I'm going to picot the hemline of my sleeves.
This is my presser foot for picot. So I have installed that, and now I'm going to picot the
hemline of my other side of the sleeve. So both the arm hemlines have been picot. I'll just snip off the excess threads. So now the final stitch for both sides of the body to be attached, and for that I'll match up first the armhole seams and pin it up here, because these are certain important joints which should perfectly match up with each other to get that beautiful finish that you want in your cloth. So we match it up. Sew it together, a quarter of an inch seam allowance. I'll start from this joint and give double stitch. So I'll bring it once here and then go back so that I have twice the stitch. So I give a double stitch here. Reach the final stage of this DIY sewing project, where we just have to finish up with the hemline for the bottom of this crop top. The bottom edges of this crop top, I'm not going to give any hemline sew to it, and I'm simply going to picot it just like I did for the hemline of my arms or the sleeves. So I've set the presser foot for picot, and I have also installed the coordinated thread, and now I'm good to go for the final picoting of the bottom hem. So let me do that and show it also to you. So this is how my crop top looks finally after ironing and getting all the edges and the corners properly ironed and in their place. So you can see the neckline as well. It's all set properly. And also I'll show you these embroidery pattern stitches which I had done with twin needle. I hope they are looking nice and also gives a
extra dimension to camouflage the stitches which were there in this DIY project. So also I'll show you the arms. This is how the arms look, and these are the edges of the hemline for the bottom of the top, with which I have done with the pico.
This was the previous crop top which I had made from another salwar of mine. This I had done just to get an idea as to how it will turn out to be, so that I have enough confidence to share this tutorial with you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video tutorial, and also will try your own such DIY projects incorporating few ideas of mine and few of your own. Do share it with your friends if you liked my idea, and also give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel. Do not forget to hit bell notification icon to be updated with all my upcoming videos. Until next time, bye.